about to do something a little honest with an honest reaction, and this is Honest Trailers, John Wick, I guess because John Wick 2 is coming out very, very soon.
Yes, and I'm looking forward to it. It's got Ruby Rose in it, not the animated character, the actress.
Who's Ruby Rose? I don't know, is a porn star or what? I don't know.
Like, she's a actress and entertainer. She's pretty cool.
Really?
Actually, yeah.
Ruby, hold on.
Ruby Rose. No, exactly. But spelled R-U-B-Y.
No, no, I'm actually looking up, when does John Wick come out for?
Here?
Yeah.
I can
tell you. I'm checking right now. John Wick 2, I want to see. Because last year, John Wick came out like a year later in
Japan, yeah.
Yeah, in Japan.
It'll come out sooner than that, but for here...
It comes out the 30th. What? The 30th? It comes out January... No, that doesn't make sense at all. February 10th, it comes out in America.
Yeah.
In...
I want to say it's July.
Oh, if it's July, yeah. So we've got a while to wait, guys.
July, July 7th, John Wick 2. Like
it always is like that. Anyways, let's... I was trying to find it really quick, but it's always so hard to get the... It might be undecided. All right. Let's go ahead and get the Honest Trailers away. There we go. All set?
Yes.
They stole his car. They killed his dog. Now, he's gonna kill 76 people who worked for the dad of the kid who did it. John Wick. Strap in for the sleeper hit of 2014 that your friends would not shut up about. Combine the no-nonsense revenge movies of the past with the slick production techniques of today. In an action flick that doesn't rely on quick cuts or shaky cam? I didn't even know you were allowed to do that. This one isn't gonna hop a fence in the next take-in.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Man, that must have taken them a while. No, seriously, that was like 14 different camera angles.
Yeah.
Meet John Wick, the man whose mere name makes criminals reconsider their life choices.
He stole John Wick's car.
Oh, John Wick.
Oh. Witness Keanu's eighth and arguably best character named John. He's a retired hitman, tragically in love with a video clip. But after the world's most depressing crime...
Days after his wife died, you steal his car and kill his f***ing dog.
He'll turn the entire world into a game of Call of Duty on the easiest difficulty.
Yeah.
To quote the man himself, enter a mysterious shadow society of assassins where everyone is way too casual about dead bodies.
Hey, John.
You, working again?
Complete with its own mysterious currency, cleanup crew, hotel, bar, healthcare, car service, and assassin jazz band, I guess? So, is there like an assassin Yelp, assassin daycare, assassin deli? I really have to clear all that up in John Wick 2. Watch as John hunts down Theon Greyjoy.
He's yeah.
gone from literally dickless to metaphorically dickless.
Want another bottle? Go get me a bottle!
In breathtaking action sequences, where John kills countless actual red shirts, culminating in a finale where he casually shoots the person he's been hunting.
Yeah, yeah.
Then wrestles an old and out-of-shape Russian dad in the ring. Kind of feels like they blew their budget in that nightclub scene.
Yeah, yeah.
So pull up a front row seat to the Keanu-sans as this immortal 50-year-old still kicks just as much ass as he did in his 20s and finally loses the trademark chill he's been building up since Bill and Ted.
Or you can die screaming alongside him!
As we pray that Keanu pulls off what he's never done before. Follow up a great action movie with a sequel that doesn't suck.
You have many questions, and though the process has altered your consciousness, you remain irrevocably human. Concurrently, while your first question may be the most pertinent, you may or may not realize it is also the most irrelevant. Your life is the sum of a remainder of an unbalanced equation inherent to the programming.
Starring I Know Kung Fu, to friend or to foe, headshots.
One of the things I love the most.
Russian Reek, Friday Night Lights Out. More headshots. Winston Churchill, Super Shredder, and Ninja Turtles 2.
Yeah! Yeah.
Wow, this movie is like 80% headshots.
Yeah.
No, right? A Dog's Purpose.
Dog's Purpose.
Man, John's so good at shooting, he doesn't even shoot vertical video. Hey, Screen Junkies, want to hear how Keanu Reeves really feels about John Wick?
I just want to kill this one kid. I'm not crazy.
Then check out our second edition of Honest Interviews, where we ask Keanu and the people behind John Wick 2 to answer our dumb questions. Click the box on the left to watch our interview, or click the box on the right to check out our Screen Junkies roast of Batman.
What?
Whoa.
What?
Always bet on black. Suit. He said, welcome to the freaking Guardians of the Galaxy. Only he didn't say freaking.
Alright, so, there we are.
I require your oats.
What? Perfect. So, that was pretty funny.
That was funny.
The, you know, they couldn't tear it apart because it was a very, very well-liked movie. So.
That, and it's a very, very linear movie.
Yes, yeah, right.
A to B. There's
but that's what it, and that's what it was exactly supposed to be, yeah. So...
I liked it.
It did feel like a video game, though.
Yeah, it did, and I did enjoy the movie. I watched it recently, and now I want to watch it again. Because when it came out, it's like the movies that were like that were John Wick, Equalizer, and
Jack Reacher.
They're all like that '80s, early '90s style action flick. Loved it.
The thing about John, I think the thing about John Wick and those type of movies, like you're saying, is I could probably watch it once and. Mm-hmm. That's probably enough for me. Like, it's not something that I would watch it through over and over again because it's kind of like, it's pretty long. Like, and I remember watching John Wick and I was just like, damn, these scenes are really good, but it's also, it's good because my friends, like they were mentioning, your friends wouldn't shut up about it and people would, you gotta see this, you gotta see this scene. And the thing that sold me on John Wick was like, oh damn, I need to finally rent this, was the scene where he just came in and the technical standpoint of with the gun and he was just popping people and reloading and how accurate
beautiful.
It was. Yeah, very well done. I'm like, okay, I need to check this movie out.
Yeah.
But
next time, you gotta watch it in the theater first.
Yeah, as long as that takes to get here. And that was the other thing, the delay killed it for me. Yeah.
Yeah.
The delay killed it for me. I think for me, I'm good with rental each time. I mean, it was still... I don't know exactly... I think the reason for me, particularly, if I was in America, I think I would love this movie, premiere night. Everybody would be like, yeah! Oh, shit! The
energy's
completely different. Here...
Everybody's quiet. No one really responds. So we usually go with a group of our friends.
Right.
That way, when something happens... You not just see it up there, but you feel it and hear it because everybody's in the row.
So the mood just is completely different. So it's kind of like, if I'm going to see a movie like this that requires that hypeness about it, I'd rather just rent it and watch it at home instead of paying $20, $30-something dollars to go see it in a bunch of quiet. I'm like, yeah!
Because everybody here, you know, it's nothing bad, but... When they watch movies, they're
Japanese
super polite,
culture,
so they don't really do loud reactions to stuff because they don't want to be rude to the person next to
them.
Understandable. And I got used to it, but I react to movies. I can't not react.
I remember watching Rogue One, and when we saw certain scenes in Rogue One, I was just like, I was the only one like, what the fuck?
And
I was like, oops.
And
like,
no one
nobody else was just, I mean, they might have been shocked internally about the last scene of Rogue One, but, like, nobody really had the same reaction.
No, for the most part, it was, Deadpool, all you hear.
Right. Deadpool was the only one where I saw people kind of break their, like,
break the
I was looking around, and I saw some Japanese people.
Younger crowd, too.
Younger crowd. Or Sausage Party. Sausage Party.
Well, that was disturbing.
Sausage Party, I saw people laughing. But like with Deadpool, I saw people wanting to laugh out loud, but they just kind of buried themselves into their boyfriend's chest or something like that. And I'm like, ah, come on, just let it out. Let it out. Anyways, the damn movie looks really good. The trailer impressed the hell out of me.
Right.
Over Super Bowl.
I'm looking forward to it.
But I will agree with it with an honest trailer. It's the one thing that did bother me was the fact that there was this huge... Great scenes, but then the final resolution just was like, I felt it was because I was just tired of, like, seeing so much action on screen, but I'm glad they kind of mentioned it. It was like, okay, here you go. You're finally going to get that guy. And he's like, it was just a fucking... And that was it. The dude just capped him and walked off. I'm like, wait, you killed all these dudes, and this was the big payoff we got? And
yeah. And you know why? Like, because he went through all those dudes only because they got in his way.
Right.
Had they not been there...
Right.
No problem. I mean, it was very... So I'm okay with that. That and looking at it, it's like he's cleaning up his old life.
Okay. It was simplistic, but yeah it was like... though. And I will say, I hope number two gets more into it, where I actually really like the... No, I just like the assassins community. Yeah. That shit was dope.
That's what...
number two is about?
That's what Common and Ruby Rose are playing.
Okay.
So that's kind of cool, because you get to see
how good they are. Another assassin.
Yeah, you said Common Assassin.
No, I'm just saying, like, a Suicide Squad. Like, how many times is Common... Wait, was he in the first one, actually? The
first.
John Wick.
Not that I remember, no.
I vaguely remember some other assassins that were kind of fairly famous or whatever, but I like...
But I don't remember him.
Okay.
I could have missed him, but I don't
recall him. It's kind of funny just to see him after Suicide Squad, so...
Well, I mean...
I don't want no beef. I don't want no beef. All right, guys, we're out. Peace.
Super.
Let us know if that movie is good over the weekend.
Yeah, definitely.
We have a few months to decide.
I have a feeling that if they have a screener for it, I'll be taking him with me so we can react to it.
I see what you did there. All my friends are heathens, take it slow.